Hi, my name is Riata Scott, and today I'm going to show you how to style hyperlinks with CSS. I'm using Dreamweaver CC here so that we can see the design view as we work, but I'll type directly into the style sheet so that those of you who are using a text editor like Notepad can easily duplicate the process. In this example, we have a navigation section here on the left. The regular blue links, I don't even know if you'll be able to see these in the recorded view, but you can just barely see them. So we want to style them in a way that they'll have a lighter color, maybe take out the underlines, so they just look like a navigation area, but they don't have the usual hyperlink properties. So over here in the CSS, I've already put in the selectors and the pseudo class selectors, in other words. So a pseudo, this is the selector for the property A. And then the pseudo is followed by a colon and then the pseudo class. In this case is link. And we've got a visited, a hover, and a active. And they have to be set up in this order. Link, visited, hover, and then active. Link is just a regular link, so normally that would just be this blue color, right? Visited is what you see after a page or website has been visited. It shows up as purple. Hover is not something that you normally have, but it's one we can add, and that's when your mouse passes over it, it will change colors. And then active, you barely see that, but that is the color it changes as you're clicking. So if you click and hold, you can see the color it'll change to. So what I'm going to do is add my properties and values in here. I'm going to go with color, C2CE14. That is this color over here. I want that here. And of course we add a semicolon and text decoration, putting none. That's going to take the underline out. Now I will, just to save a little time, copy and paste this into the others. So we have the visited and my hover. And active. All right, so visited, what do I want to do? Let's just change that color to, I wonder if we can pick up a pale color like this one. Let's just make it easy. I'm going to make that, let's say light gray, just so we can see it. Hover, let's just go with a orange so you can see it. And active, let's go with yellow. All right, on my hover, I would like my text decoration to come back. So I'll go ahead and put underline in there. And I'm going to click Save All. And you can see here's a problem over here. We can read them over here, they're working. I'm hovering over them, they're turning orange. If I click and hold one, it turns yellow. But the problem is when we do it this way, when we actually use the element in the style sheet, it changes the color of them everywhere. And we don't want that here. A lot of times a website will have the content area in white, but the navigation will, you'll want that in white also. And of course that just makes these invisible until someone hovers over them. So that's not optimal. So what we're going to do instead is, let's take a look at the actual source code here, where we are in the hours. So we're in a class called navigation. All right, that's good. Let me go on back to this. So let's just add that class in front of these. So it would be dot navigation. And then I will just copy and paste this in the other three. What this will do is ensure that these color choices we've made will only happen here, and that the regular content will still have the blue and purple underlined links that everyone's used to seeing. So when someone gets to your page, they can just scan and immediately see what's a hyperlink. Okay, so I'll save all and come back here to, well, I don't even have to because we have this in live view. I was going to open it up in a web page. But now you can see our regular links are back, and only the navigation has these colors that we gave it. If you'd like to learn more about HTML and CSS, the IT Training Department offers a series of HTML5 and CSS classes, which are free to University of Missouri-Columbia students, faculty, and staff. Log on to training.missouri.edu and sign up today.